protocol T, as a reminder, randomized 660 patients with center-involved DME and some vision loss of 20/32 to 20/320 to treatment with aflibercept, bevacizumab, or ranibizumab for 2 years under a structured retreatment protocol. The primary outcome was the change in vision from baseline, and the secondary outcome was the change in the central subfield thickness on OCT. There was a pre-specified subgroup analysis that showed that eyes with better baseline vision, 20/32 to 20/40, there was no difference between the three agents with a mean gain of about 8 letters in 2 years. But in eyes with worse baseline vision, aflibercept was superior to the other two at 1 year, but only to bevacizumab at 2 years. So we were interested in bringing patients in after the study ended at 2 years for a 5 year visit, 3 years after the study ended, 5 years from their enrollment, and see how they were doing after 3 years of leaving the study. One problem with the study is that DME and diabetic retinopathy management were at clinician discretion. They were not part of the protocol between years 2 and 5, so you need to remember that. At the 5 year visit, ocular and medical history was obtained, medical records were reviewed, a protocol refraction for visual acuity was obtained, an eye exam was done, and OCT and color photos were done. So, the primary objective of the T extension study was, first, we wanted to look at treatment course. Did patients continue care with a retina specialist? What treatments had they been given, and how often? We wanted to know about the vision. What was the vision change from baseline and between the 2 year and 5 year visit? What about the status of the macula? What was the change in CST from baseline and then from 2 to 5 years? How many eyes still had DME in 5 years? So the main objective, however, did not include comparing treatment groups after 2 years, because as I said, there was no structured retreatment, and the data could be confounded by clinicians and patients' awareness of the treatment group and the protocol T results. So there were 558 patients that were eligible for the extension. 67%, 317, agreed to come in for a 5 year visit. These 317 patients were equally distributed between baseline treatment groups, but there was better baseline vision and 2 year vision in the participants compared to the non participants, though the OCT was similar in comparison. 95% of patients had at least one retinal exam between 2 years and 5 years. And the mean number of exams was 14. And 98% of these visits occurred at a protocol T clinical site, so follow-up or continuity of care for these patients was actually quite good for the participant. 70% of patients had at least one treatment for DME or diabetic retinopathy, and this was predominantly anti-VEGF therapy, with aflibercept being the most commonly employed agent. Only 10% received a corticosteroid injection, and only 8% received focal laser. About a third of patients in the, when you look at the baseline treatment groups, about a third in all three never received an injection between years 2 and 5. As in the aflibercept group, were the least likely to receive an alternative anti-VEGF agent. The median number of injections given in the 3 years was 4. And less than 10% of patients received 20 or more injections. So as opposed to what we experienced with AMD patients, the need for continuous therapy was uncommon. So at the 5 year visit, the mean gain in vision overall for the group was 12 letters. But by the 5 year visit, this had declined 5 letters to 7 letters gain. So there was still a gain from baseline, but just not as robust. When you look at vision according to the baseline treatment assignment, we saw similar and parallel decline in all, using with all three agents. Also, when you look at the vision on baseline subgroup of better vision or worse vision, you also see a similar decline from 2 years to 5 years. However, about half of the patients had excellent vision of 20/25 or better at the 5 year visit, and very few eyes had poor vision of 20/200 or worse. So the mean reduction in central subfield thickness in 2 years was 156 microns for the full cohort, and this was stable through 5 years. Looking at the CST by treatment assignment, bevacizumab was less effective than the other two through 2 years of reducing the edema. but this difference disappeared by the five-year visit, and there was equivalence at that time point. About 60% of the patients had a normal OCT at the five-year visit, as judged by the CST being less than 250 microns stratus equivalent. So there are limitations to the study. Only two-thirds of eligible participants came in for a five-year visit, and the baseline vision and two-year vision were better in participants than in non-participants. Also, we cannot compare treatment groups because, as I said, treatment was not standardized between years two and five. Additionally, the data collection was retrospective. So in conclusion, 95% of patients received retinal care and 68% received at least one anti-VEGF injection. The mean visual acuity worsened between 2 and 5 years, though there was still a gain from baseline. This is interesting given the fact that the OCT seemed stable during that time, so it was not because of recurrent edema. These results differ from previous studies that have demonstrated better maintenance of vision, such as in protocol I. So this just seems to point out that we need new strategies to improve long-term outcomes in eyes with DME. Thank you very much for your attention.